Hi, Alan Hadley with MyPhoto Networks. Thanks for joining me for this next video tutorial, Focus Spotlight, Shooting Patterns. In this video tutorial, we're going to illustrate how to shoot and discuss patterns. Now, when you're out shooting, there's patterns everywhere. What you have to be able to do as the photographer is actually see those patterns and use the light available to create the best image. So, with that said, let's get started. To look at a very simplistic image, and as you can see, these are silos. They're grain silos, and they are lined up in a row on the side of an old country road. While I was out traveling, I saw these, and it was late in the afternoon. Now, the key to making an image like this successful is not only your perspective, but the light that's actually affecting the subject. As you can see, the light's coming from the right-hand side, coming across, so I'm shooting into the shadow. Now, as you'll recall, in other video tutorials and things we've talked about, shooting into the shadow really creates a lot of depth. But what you have is actually the lines that are not only vertically, but the lines that are running horizontally. So what we're doing is we're creating a number of different patterns by choosing the right perspective here. By shooting more to the rear of the image, in other words, to the left-hand side, shooting across the image, we are creating these horizontal lines with that are actually on the subject itself. But we also have the vertical lines because there's four individual silos. And then at the bottom of the image, we also have the post or the little vertical posts that go across the bottom of the image and fade off into the right. This is another set of patterns. And what you want to do when you're looking for or looking at something like this is to pay attention to the whole image, not just the fact that it's a repetitious subject matter, but what's happening in the image, the story that the image is actually telling, how this light is affecting this image, and how your perspective is going to create this image the way you see it. Now, your focal length is really important. In this particular image, I was using a very long focal length lens. So what that did is take my perspective and stack it, kind of squish it up together. If I shot this with a much wider focal length lens, of course my image would have appeared or visually appeared much longer and wider. So what I decided to do is use a longer focal length lens to stack those images together because of everything that's actually going on in the image. So with that said, let's go to a different type of pattern image and take a look at a different effect. In this particular image, there's several elements going on that help us build the image itself. We have a road, we have a railing, and we have light post. Now, if you'll notice, on all three of those elements, there are patterns. There's horizontal lines that go across the road that lead you back into the image. There are vertical and horizontal lines on the railing that lead you back into the image. And then there's the light post that give you a repetition or a series of patterns going back into the image. The whole point here is to drag the viewer into the image and give them something to look at, telling the story, and that's what we were talking about before. When you're framing up an image like this, be cognizant of the perspective and the focal length that you're using. Now, I chose an 80 to 400 millimeter lens on this. I was actually very far away from this image when I shot it, and I shot it at 400 millimeter, but I also shot it using a tripod so that I had no shake, because I wanted everything in the image to be tack sharp. The idea here is to illustrate all of these different patterns that are located in this particular image. Now, the lighting that's associated to this image is really what makes this image stand out. Now, my perspective, choice of focal length, and the way I expose the image is also very, very important. Now, in this particular image, there was this huge rock wall that was behind this whole scene. Now, it was shaded because of the direction of the sun. So when I drove up and saw this particular image, I knew before I ever shot the picture that when I post-process this image, I could get rid of that wall and really illustrate all the different patterns in this particular image. The direction of the sun was really important because it made the lights on the light pole actually stand out, makes them appear like they're actually on, when in fact they weren't. But all of the different patterns in this is what we were going after in this particular shot. So with that said, let's look at another set of patterns. The main element of this image is the trees itself. But let's look at the clouds and the position of the clouds and the shadowing that's in the foreground. All of these things come into play to make the image what it is. The shadowing takes us from the right-hand side of the frame into the image up to the left-hand corner. And then the trees drag us across the image. And when we get to the last tree, our eye tends to go up to our clouds. Now, if you'll notice, in the middle of the frame, at the top part of the image, actually more to the left, there's a little cloud that's in the center of the frame. That little cloud is a stopping point. That little cloud actually brings your eye to that point and then brings you back into the image. So it's kind of like a big stop sign. When you're framing up your composition, pay attention to everything that's in the shot, because when the viewer looks at this particular image, they want to have a pleasing experience. They want to be able to not only see everything, but they also want to be able to get impact from the image. And that is a combination of things that you do as the photographer to create that look and feel. Patterns do not have to be any particular type of subject. They can be any number of combinations of things that are repetitious. As you can see in this particular shot, these are tracks going through a field. Now, the idea here is to show the repetition in the image itself. When you see things like this, take the required time to really look at the image and find the best composition and the best perspective. Pay attention to the focal length that you're using, and pay attention to your exposure. All of these elements come together to make a great image. So, with that said, that brings us to the end of this video tutorial. I appreciate you joining us, and I look forward to our next.